the new NWA Upstate Heavyweight Champion, Ivan, and his name is Brodie Lee.
I am Harper, formerly known as Brodie Lee, formerly known as Huber Boy 2, and formerly known as Jonathan Huber.
This is kind of like, I would say, where it all began in a professional wrestling ring. It's just a martial arts place. We had fans, we sold tickets, it was pretty cool. We would put a ring up and have shows, and the first couple, we would just wrestle the guys that we knew. And then from there, as time went on, of course, professional wrestling just allows you to mix and mingle, and then we all became friends. We all decided what we wanted. Well, and that was just to be in a ring.
Hey, man. How are you?
Good to see you, man.
Welcome back.
Good to see you.
Good to see you,
How
too.
How are you?
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It's been a whirlwind tour for you.
Holy cow, yeah.
Congratulations,
Thank
man.
You very
that's,
much,
that's
man.
That's fabulous on your success.
Thank you for your
access. Very proud of you, man. It's,
this is where it started.
Fantastic. I know you're going to bring back memories of flying out.
I was shaking. So this is literally where we'd put the ring, right here.
Yeah, we'd open up this door.
So we'd open up this, put the ring here, we'd dress back there, yep. And we'd have an entranceway.
We'd have curtains hung.
Yep.
You guys come through the door.
Yep.
And this would be all chairs
lit up.
Side.
Yep, chairs over there, mostly full for the most part. And
I see the old pulley up there is where we used to pull up the lit sign that said Rock City Wrestling.
Holy cow. We had no idea what we were doing. Luckily, he kind of was there to guide us because we just wanted to get in the ring and wrestle, and we didn't care about the people. We didn't care about anything. But then he kind of said, hey, man, we can put people here and they'll watch you. You don't give these to your friends and family. And we said, okay. So then they started coming. When I was here in this venue, it was just kind of like a fun thing to do, but not in my wildest dreams did I think that this was gonna be a job for me.
Friday night, sometimes we do about, on an average, about 150 to 200 spectators.
And in here, because it was only the two sides, and you'd have people standing on the window, it was awesome.
Yeah.
Great. Yeah. So it's Huber Boy 2 here.
Hailing from Huber Boy.
I was Huber Boy 2. Huber Boy 1 is a chemist. he was also a referee. He was supposed to be a wrestler. He took one choke slam, said, maybe this isn't for me, I'll be a referee. And all the other Huber Boys were never really spoken of. Because the problem was we only had two, and we didn't know what to do after that.
Huber Boy 2 is just John Huber. Goofy, fun-loving, in a singlet and shorts, and literally just me being me. I was told quickly to change my name and to change my character, that I'm so big that you're wasting something. I was like, oh, come on, guys, you know. Thought they were idiots. They might have been onto something. I'm super proud of Rochester, and I'm super proud of what Rochester is and what Rochester represents. I always wanted to be here. I kind of wanted to, instead of leave Rochester, I would prefer to have people associate Rochester with me and bring Rochester up. So I actually did leave and go to Florida for 2 years to go to developmental Tampa for a year, then Orlando for a year. And then we came back because I love it here. And Rochester is a very special place. This is where I spent probably about 75% of my time between 2007 and 2011. My shoes are still up there. To see like almost like a measure of what, I guess you can't measure what happened in here, so. If that's as close as it gets, like that's, I guess that's it. By this point, I had been, I guess, trained, but was working more and learning the ins and outs of the actual business. So what would you say, you two?
I mean, just honing, at that point, you're just kind of honing what you wanted to be, your vision. I mean, I used to remember, you know, that you'd be a big man, but you wanted to be a little dude.
I know for me personally, riding the road with them, there were often times where you'd have a 4 o'clock conversation on the ride home where John would say, I'm never gonna get the chance, I'm never gonna get a break from these guys. And we kept telling him that he has size, he has agility, someone's eventually gonna see it.
From 2007 to 2011, I grew leaps and bounds. And this guy put me in the ring with people every month. That's what literally is the thing that bumped me to the next level. that and watching these guys work on the road to Ring of Honor, that stuff is what made me more than what I was then, I guess. Well, Brodie Lee was born in a diner. The name is derived from looking like Jason Lee and Mallrats, whose name is Brodie Bruce, so Brodie Lee. 2007, I went to Chikara and was asked by Mike Quackenbush to change my character, not my name, Brodie Lee's cool, but to change into a dirty, roving truck driver type character that got lost on the roads, and here he is, he's this big, burly badass. I was open to it. It was terrifying because I was definitely in a comfort zone, definitely happy with what I was doing. So for someone to ask me to change my gear, first off, I thought, that's not what professional wrestlers wear. Once that kind of happened, that's where wrestling became more of a business and a reality to me of what it was, and when the bigger and bigger things started coming, when the character changed. I did extra work for the WWE, and I remember like the last time we did it in Buffalo, I said, you know what, I'm not gonna go to the ring and work out, because I literally thought, I'm just here to fill a spot on a paper. And I was home by the time Raw started, and I thought, like, this is it, this is the closest I'm ever gonna get. Then I dislocated my patella on a Dragon Gate USA show in New York City, drove home. My wife, she said, hey, actually I have to tell you something. I was like, oh, what's up? She's like, oh, I'm pregnant. So now I have a busted leg, my wife is pregnant. A day later, I was told I lost my job. That week, I like to say, defined me as a person more than anything that's ever happened before or could happen. That was one of my lowest lows, but at the same time, I had a child on the way, so one of my highest highs, but I didn't know how to react or how to deal with any of that yet. Of course, at that time, Johnny Ace calls. He said, hey kid, you know, we want to hire you. And I said, it's a message though. So I'm listening to this message. Call me back at this number. 203, phone cuts out. I call Cesaro and I said, please tell me you have Johnny Ace's number. And he said, oh yeah, here you go. So I run into the hall and I call him. Hey Johnny, this is Jonathan Huber. You just called me. Phone cuts out. And I'm like, oh my God, oh my God. So of course I call Johnny back, no answer. And I'm freaking out now. And of course, 2 minutes later, there's the call. And he said, yeah, you know, we want to hire you and da, 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 da. And then, so everything was cool.
Sitting at NXT TV. And then I became the first son of the Wyatt family on TV. And then Rowan was added and we became a tag team.
We did a match at NXT and got pulled in the back. Hunter said, I just want to tell you guys that you guys are going on the road. I just remember the feeling of, oh my God, I did it. I did it.
Down to the sea.
It's cool to me to, and I hold on to so much stuff from my wrestling that I have the card from when I wrestled Undertaker. I have posters. I have all the posters we've been on. I have all my figures. And I have them not for me, but someday I maybe want to hand them to my son and say, hey, here. And if he wants it or not, but I've been given the opportunity to give that to him. And he's one of the biggest fans in the world. So for him to be able to see what I've done and the person that it's made me, I can't really describe it. It's, I guess if I had a goal in life, it was to be as good a dad as my dad, and I think I'm on my way. And I guess for me to be able to do that, it's super special.
As much as you know you want to talk about like John Huber's, you know, as a person, Huber Boy 2, Brodie Lee, Luke Harper are all Jonathan Huber, and I'm that because of those three personalities, I guess, and it's professional wrestling. Made me what I am. It's very powerful.